can't tell you how long ago, but it's over 35 years ago, when I was trying to do films, and I was deeply involved in advertising, I was obsessed with Jack London and his stories, mainly because they were public domain and therefore were accessible to me to make short movies or make a movie. And so, in other words, it was cheap. And they were great, great single storylines that worked well for a film that might run an hour and a half to an hour and 45 minutes. So I combed through the entire Jack London estate, trying to carve out those which are most appropriate as stories. And one of the things that we came across was his fascination with the universe of White Horse, which very much resembles the idea and notion of Dawson City. Because in White Horse, of course, it was the gold rush. And the way that that city, or that place, that environment evolved was bizarre in the sense of it lasted for almost 1 year. In that year, a bottle of scotch could be $100, an egg could be $25, a loaf of bread could be $50. And so everything changed its values and its price ranges. But also, even more interesting, there was no murder and there was no thieving in that particular year. So oddly enough, the availability of such enormous amounts of cash produced honest people. I hope that's the answer anyway. But anyway, that's how it came about. And when I heard in this story, this particular evolution of that kind of idea, that there was a character in it called Jack London, my ears picked up and I thought, wow, this is really interesting. And but in fact, it's evolved beyond that. It's with the great characters we've gotten there of Abby Cornish and Tim Roth and Sam Shepard, bringing this whole world alive. And what I've seen of it, and I've now seen most of it, it really is kind of wonderful. And they've really captured the environment fantastically well.